I think we're ready for the power up. Let's go. What do we do? Boom! Yeah, you don't mess with the Nothosaurus. What's going on, guys? And welcome back to another episode of Arc Aberration Ascended. Last we left off, we went with the Barry, and we went on our second cave adventure. I think the Baryonyx is somewhere down here. Let me take a look. So yeah, the Baryonyx is down there. And we went into the Blue Zone cave, and we got our second artifact. I believe it's the Artifact of the Shadows, I do believe. But yeah, we went and did that. And then on our way home, we came across a 125 Nothosaurus, and in today's video, we are going to go ahead and tame that. Now, what I've done off camera was... I didn't mean to do that, I meant to do this. What I did off camera was I got 3 power generators and about 100 and some odd gasoline. We are going to need that for the tame, because they'll destroy the power generators. You put them down, turn them on, and that's how they tame. You destroy them, so... With the rock drake, we don't even need the elevator anymore, so we could just rock climb if we wanted to. Because we got plenty of biotoxin, I wouldn't want to waste it. Alright. So Mr. Rock Drake, which I don't have a name for you yet. I thought of a name, but I immediately forgot it. Alright, here we are. So, yeah, there's the Artifact of the Shadows right there, and the other artifact, the Artifact of the Depths. So, where's the fridge? Oh, the downstairs, right? Alright, let's put the biotoxin in here so we're all set to go. We got an Allosaurus brain last episode. And we got some stuff from drops that we should put away immediately. Alright, we've got everything we need. Let's go ahead and see if we can do this. We probably might need a saddle, but we'll worry about the saddle, like, later on. Let's see, hold on. Nothosaurus. What does it take to make the saddle? You craft it by hand, and it's 25 metal, 150 fiber, and 270 hide. Alright. That should be good to go. And you know what? I've been thinking about this for a little bit. We've got a pyromane. As long as I put it back in the drop, I remember to put it back in here before the series ends. And I think we could just do this in here, I think. Creatures? Yeah, we could just download the creature in here. Alright, the only one we can download is the Carnotaurus and the Pyromane. The rest of them are not allowed on Aberration. Here we go. Our blue Pyromane from the Center series has returned to us. I still haven't thought of a name for you yet. You're a blue male. You are like a max level male. I'm gonna put you away for now. And we're gonna use you to cook up some metal. I'm gonna see if I can make the saddle like right now. Because I really can't be bothered to get wood at the moment. Like enough wood. I mean, we have the roll rack, but still. I really can't be bothered. This is much easier. Yeah, I didn't want to bring this guy into Aberration, but we kind of don't have a choice. Alright. So how do we... Fire source, turn that to highest. And then that's how we light up the refining forge, I do believe. Alright, we could bring you into the blue zone, but there's a lot of water. Okay, I didn't want to jump up there anyway. You know what? There's a drop. I'm gonna see if I can grab that drop. Alright, stop launching yourself in the air. Jesus. We'll go to the blue zone. Just give me a minute. No, I don't want you to climb down. I want you to climb up. There we go, so we can get this drop. Okay, Rock Drake, what are you doing? What are you doing, Rock Drake? Oh my god, why is this creature... No, I don't want you to climb down. I want you to climb up. Thank you. Right, let me grab this drop real quick. an Arthroplura saddle. Was it worth it? Not really. There's also a blue drop up here. Why is the rock drake so hard to control? Or is this a purple drop? I think this is purple. Oh, we got some ammonite bile, one mutton, and some boots. Was it really worth it? Not really. Alright. Can we jump to the building from here? Can we latch onto this wall? No, we're going to the ground. Okay, whatever. And the fire is lit. Awesome. Thanks to the pyromane, the fire is lit. Alright, so we got 124 metal. Let's go get some fiber and some hide. We should have some fiber in here. Alright, is it enough? Nothosaurus. What's this? Admin menu remote. 55,575 metal ingots, and that's for all five of them. Okay, so 55,575 times 5. 277,875 metal ingots. Nobody has the inventory space for that. I'm pretty sure no creature is, and I had metal in here. Oh, cool. Alright, so we got the fiber. Alright, all we need is hide. Do we have any hide in here? We sure do. And let me just put the leftover resources in here. Alright, we should be good to go. Alright, we're crafting, so we can't really do anything. Alright, let's get back on the pyromane. Maybe bring you inside, so you don't get eaten by anything. Because your only purpose, really, is to light up the fire right now. We might use you for riding adventures, but that's about it. Alright, where's the refining forge? I think it's down here. We'll put you up here. Should reach it from up here, right? There we go. You know what? I'm trying to think. We could name you after, I mean, you look like a nebula, but you're a male. Nebulo. Not quite a nebula, but a nebulo. Yeah, that'll be your name. That'll be your name. And you've got 100,000 health, which is good. Alright, your only job is to light the fire, basically. I should probably get you some food. So you don't, you know, starve to death. I want to save you for, like, an actual series where you'll be useful for other stuff aside from this. Because pyromanes, they're cool and all, but we just use them in the center. There wouldn't be any point in using this here. Alright, let me just get you some food. Yeah, you're already draining your food. Alright. Let's-a-go. On another Blue Zone adventure. So this 125 Nothosaurus should be around here. While we're down there, we'll search for more Megalosaurs or maybe a high-level male Baryonyx. See if we can get maybe a Megalosaurus with better stats or a high-level male Baryonyx. That's the Ravagers. I should probably keep an eye out for any more high-level Ravagers. They might have better stats. Maybe better health or better melee than Rampage did. So far, Rampage... A game. Thank you. So far, Rampage has the best stats. There's a 55 Megalosaurus somewhere. There's a 15 Antrodemus. Is there a max level something? A 130, but it's a male. There's a 130 spider, but it's a male. Yeah, if you were a female, I'd definitely tame you. Because the females are the ones that we have to tame first. That's a Majungasaurus. First time I've seen one of those, that's a level 70. Not the greatest level, but I think I do have to kill one of them for their... for something. I think it's their saliva or something. Yeah, it's this stuff. Parasitic saliva. So basically what this stuff does, you consume it on yourself, and then it does, for some reason, it gives you the power to do more torpor to a Majungasaurus when you eventually tame them. Don't ask me how that works. It just does. Because they have a very high resistance to torpor. We got an Antrodemus. If I can find a high level, that's a 5. This Megalosaurus is a 95. Let's give it to you. Alright, hello, what are you? 50 spider? Alright, this 125, I think this is it. This is it, the 125 Nothosaurus, and it's still by itself. Alright, let's get rid of this Arthropleura. So how this works, you gotta place a power generator down, turn it on, and then, ooh, Shinehorn. What level are you? 80. Alright, I almost said 50 then. Alright, so what you do is you put the power generator here. Turn it on. We'll make 2. And that'll attract the Nothosaurus. I think we do have to be not mounted. I'm gonna make sure you are on passive, Rock Drake. Oh yeah. This should be easy. 125 Nothosaurus being tamed up. Since this is so easy, we could easily try to find a high-level female, or high-level male in this case. This one will tame. And there we have it. Nothosaurus has been tamed. Only a 125. Let me put the saddle on top of you. And you're very heavy, probably because I have the Rock Drake's inventory on me. Alright, so let me take some of this meat. Put some of it in your inventory. Drop the rest. And then just drop everything. Oh, we got the Allosaurus brain just in case we maybe find a high-level Antrodemus. We might tame that, like, maybe next episode or something. Alright. So we got the parasitic saliva, anyway. So if we find a high-level Majungasaurus... Wait, I think we're ready to use our... Let's see what we do with this. 2,500 already. That's really good. And I got the perfect name for you, too. You can be Storm. Storm the Nothosaurus. And let's take a screenshot of the thumbnail. Yep. And this isn't all, don't worry. There we go. Alright, let's check your stats out. Maybe see if you've got good stats or whatever. You probably don't, but... I mean, you're a 125, so maybe you might have good stats. Alright, let me get on the Rock Drake where it's safer. Alright. 45 points into health is really good. 39 into stamina, oxygen, food, no one cares. 40 into weight, and 24 into melee. The melee is kind of terrible. But the rest of the stats... pretty good, actually. Alright, so we got this power generator. Since it's been recently damaged, yeah, we won't be able to pick it up. So let's go ahead and demolish that for maybe resources and whatever. There we go. Alright. If we could find a high-level male, is that a max level? No, it's a level 5. I was going to say it detects a max level. Hello, that is a max level female thorax spider. That's just what we need. There's a Nothosaurus here, lovely. That's a 50 male, alright. Okay. If I could mark you down on the map. And, alright, how does this work? No, it's map, isn't it? Maybe if we got the ghillie armor. If we can get some bug spray going... I'm pretty sure they will take the prime. 17 prime, though. I mean, will they take kibble? I'm sure they will, but you know what? What I might do... I'll see if I can get some mashed insects. I tamed one without the shield, so we don't really need a shield. But that's... Alright, 35, Ravager, let's get rid of you. So let me get the things needed for the spider. And then we'll see what we can do. Alright. We might be taming a spider as well. We've got a level 10, a level 35. Or we could tame a max level Majungasaurus. Because that's a traditional knockout tame. We could easily do that. Alright, how are we going to do this without killing it? There's a 50 and there's a max level. Alright, Mr. Crab, come and get me. That's right. Can't believe we got a max. We got a max level Majungasaurus. Open for the taking. So we, if we consume one of these, we should be able to... Alright. That was a miss. There we go. Bloodthirsty. Alright, cool. Yeah, there we go. This will make it a lot easier, I think. Can't believe it. A max level Majungasaurus and a max level spider. Oh, don't you dare run away from me. Alright, turn around, Rock Drake. Alright, at least they separated. Mushtree, get out the way. Alright, which one are you? You're the 50, so you're the max level. You're the one we want. Okay, I'd rather you not be in the water. This was not part of the agenda, by the way. Okay, please get out of the water. I should have brought the Barry. I honestly should have brought the Barry. Alright, please, Mr. Majungasaurus, get out of the water. Get back on land where you belong. And down he goes. Awesome. Alright. I can't believe it. A max level Majungasaurus. 30 points into health doesn't seem too bad. Sorry, do I have any prime on my inventory? Of course I do. I am just super prepared today. I heard a Ravager. Are you the max level spider? You're a 25. Alright, so what I'll do... How long is that going to take? That's going to take 3 prime. I will see you guys when this Majungasaurus is fully tamed. And there we have it. Majungasaurus has been tamed. So just eat up the primes, good sir. Alright, we got that. We'll check your stats when we get home. So... I'm thinking next episode we get the mashed bugs, that's a level 15 Ravager and a 45, or mashed insects even. We get some of those mashed insects, and then we go ahead and tame that max level spider, if it's still there. Can't believe we got a max level Majungasaurus. I cannot believe that. If we wanted to, we've still got 7 saliva, we can get another one if we wanted to. Today just turned into a very convenient day. I mean, oh, hello. You're the level 50. I'm going to go ahead and kill you for some more saliva. Okay, so you get 8 each time. All right, so we've got 15 saliva. So if we wanted to, we could tame 15 Majungs. Oh, Jesus. God damn it. Jellyfish. Recently hurt. Come on. Who added in this recently hurt crap? Like, if a creature's been recently injured, you can't capture it. What the hell's up with that? Capture denied. Deny my ass! How about that? I just don't get why they added that in. That was never a thing in Evolved. Why is it a thing here? That is stupid. Isn't that the point of the whole, like, Pokeball thing? Isn't the point being to, that's an alpha basilisk. Isn't the point of that to, like, get the creature away from danger? Oh, let's kill this quick. Basilisk. As long as we don't end up killing the max level by accident. Alright, so you know what? Today was a really good day. We managed to get that Nothosaurus, which was, you know, pretty easy to tame. But we also got a bonus tame, a max level Majungasaurus. We'll just have to hope it's really good. Alright, so we'll take the Nothosaurus out, and we'll test you out in a minute. Damn, you are a long boy. You are long. That's what she said. Alright, so, let's check out the... You know, let's put you away for now. I have a better idea. Make it a little faster. Alright. So for stats, what do we got for the Majungasaurus? Please be good. I'm expecting at least maybe 45 into health and maybe 40 into melee. Let's see. 39 into health. All right. Not too bad. 38 into stamina. Oxygen, food, no one cares. 38 into weight. Of course, the highest stat is into food. Why couldn't that 45 be into health or melee and 30 into melee? Not great. But you know what? I'm glad we got it. So this is the Majungasaurus. I'll have to get you a saddle, but you know, it's good. You start off with 5,500 health, which is also really good. All right, so let me see if I can get a saddle for this guy. Majungasaurus. What do we need? 30 metal, 200 fiber, and 350 hide. Not too bad. Not bad at all. I do believe we're using up all our fiber from the vault, from the base area. But I'm pretty sure the rock drake dropped some fiber. I mean, some hide. Majungasaurus. Yep, there we go. Everything we need is in there. Alright, we could test out the Majungasaurus. We'll test that out second. Let's put some stuff away. Wait, I just thought of an even better name. Sapphire, spelt with an F instead of a PH. Get it? Sapphire. Actually, you know what? Sapphire. No, you know, I think we get it. I think we get it. Spelt with an F instead of a PH. Oh, and you cook meat too. Awesome. You know what? I haven't had cooked meat in a hot minute. Bring that over here. And then, once we've tested these creatures out, we'll end the episode off by doing some more breeding and see what we get for more eggs. Maybe we'll get some more mutations or whatever. We might finally get another mutation on the Spino, because I haven't really been lucky with the Spinos yet. We got 3 mutations with the Ravagers, but only 1 mutation with the Spino. Let's see what we got in here. More metal. You know what? I'll take all the metal we can get. Metal is a little tricky to come by on here. Right, let's look around. The Spino, that's the 60. You know what's killing you? I'm still looking for a high-level Spino. Not actively searching for one, but just making sure it's there. Let's start with the Nothosaurus. I will use this bulb dog as a tester. The left click does 572. For a 125, and for something with, what's that, terrible health? Or, sorry, terrible melee, that's not bad. Alright, what's right click again? Tail whip. It was so powerful we couldn't see whatever it was. Oh, hello, Protoceratops. How do you do? You guys are passive tames, right? Yeah. Let's see if we could see that. 895. Okay, that's more like it. Alright, so the more things we kill, the more we power up. I think the Tail Whip does have a cooldown. Alright, I think we're ready for the power up. Let's go. What do we do? Boom! Yeah, you don't mess with the Nothosaurus. There we go. What now? Nothosaurus is pretty much unstoppable. We've got 56 levels. Let's go up into health. Maybe get you up to, say, 30k. Get your weight up to 1,000. Stamina's fine. Put the rest into melee. Ugh. You can go away. Majungasaurus, let's put you up to the test. Alright. So this is what we look like on the top of a Majungasaurus. And we can shoot off the back of you. That's always good. I know I can do that on the Majungasaurus or the Nothosaurus, but we can shoot off the back of this guy as well. Okay, let me save the game just in case. 260 damage. How does it increase over time? I think it increases over time. Alright, and we're healing. We're like constantly healing. Or rapid regeneration. Well, that's pretty cool, actually. You know what? This guy's pretty cool. And then each time we kill things, I think the timer resets. No, it doesn't. I don't think. Alright, we're bloodthirsty. Let's see how much damage we do. It's Aquaticus. About 300 damage. But I think the attacks, the damage increases each time. Alright, keeps pushing me away. The Diplodocus was kind of a bad example of whatever. Alright, let's level up a bit. We got 49 levels. Excuse me while... Oh no, this Carno's not after me. Alright. Let's get up to, like, maybe 50,000 health. We could easily get to 100,000. Easy. There we go. Maybe put some points into weight. And then put the rest into melee. Let's go into bloodthirsty mode again. Let's see how much damage we do now. 1,100. 1,900. Okay, that's way better. Again. Also, it's if we, like, kill something big. So, like, a bug won't count. Or if it's something that fights back, maybe. Yep, the healing is rapid to me. So it kind of has like the Argentavis thing, where when it kills something and it harvests a dead body, it can regenerate health at a rapid pace. That's very interesting. You know what? Glad I tamed this guy. Really glad I tamed this guy. He may not have the greatest stats, but overall, really cool. We got that. Alright, let's finish off the episode with some breeding. So for the Ravagers, we are looking for a 230, and we're looking for a 224 with the Bears. So 230, or sorry, 232. Nothing, what about 234, alright? 224 for the... I don't know why we keep getting 224 Ravagers. Did we get like a double mutation at some point? I think we might have. Alright, we got no mutations from anything, so let's go ahead and get rid of those. Alright, let's go. Yeah, we got... Hey! Hey, what you doing? Get off my base, you. There was just a Yi-Ling latched onto my base. Damn, those Yi-Lings, they don't even care. They really don't care. Alright, for roll rats, we need 134. 134. We've got a 134. And... it's a double health mutation. Okay. What about 136, actually? Nope. Alright. We got a male with a double health mutation. So we can go ahead. H1, you can go into retirement. And then H2 will take over. Rorots can sit down? When was this a thing? I need to see this. Oh, that's enable public seating. I thought they could sit down. That would have been super cool if they could. More creatures should be able to sit down. And you've kind of got orange on you. So this is the double health mutation Rorat. Alright, so we'll start with the Gigantoraptors. So what did I say we needed for stats? Alright, Nanny, let me check your stats. You've got 32 melee and 31 health. And you've got 31 health, so the health stays the same, and you've got 21 melee. Okay, so we need like a male and a female that keeps the stats. Alright, whatever. Alright, let's start with the Megalosaurs. Alright, we got the perfect ones. We need a 220 for a mutation. 220. That's a female. Wait, we got a double one? Oh, we got a double mutation. 222. We'll check the 221 first. It is a health mutation, which kind of sucks. It sucks because it's a female. If it was a male, then great. And then we got this one with an oxygen and melee mutation. Alright, you're not a male, so I'm going to have to get rid of you. Let's go with the Gigantoraptors next. So we need 30... I think it's 32 health, 31 melee. The melee we don't have to worry about too much. Alright. No, sorry, it's the health we don't have to worry about too much. Alright, you lost the melee. Lost the melee. Alright, you kept the stats. So I'm going to go ahead and take you. You're a 172. 170. You kept the stats. I think those would be perfect. Kept the stats. I think the rest we can kill. We'll let these three grow up. Two of these will be our breeding pairs. We got two 151s and a 172. So we'll see if we can get two with the same health or the same level, and then we'll go from there. And moving on to the Spinos, we need a 212. Come on, give me a 212. I mean, a 214 would be great too, but 212. And they're female. What did we get? Oxygen and oxygen. They're both oxygen. Alright, let's get rid of them. Alright, so on my spare time, I'll grow those Gigantoraptors up. And so in today's episode, we tamed a Nothosaurus and we tamed a Majungasaurus. But yeah, and with that, that's going to have to wrap it up for this episode. If you guys enjoyed it, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more. It would really help out a ton. But until next time, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.